Come in, performance, due to popular demand, they're back again, so put your hands together for the Coachmen.
Some come to dance,
some come to play,
some merely come to pass time away.
Others do laugh, their voices do ring, but as for me, I come for to sing.
Because there's a meeting here tonight. There's a meeting here tonight. I know you by your friendly face. There's a meeting here tonight.
There's a meeting here tonight. There's a meeting here tonight. I know you by your friendly face. There's a meeting here tonight. There's a meeting here tonight. Great God, I'm glad you came along. Hope all the brothers and sisters here will help me sing this song. There's a meeting here tonight. There's a meeting here tonight. I know you by your friendly face. There's a meeting here tonight. There's a grin on every upper face and a smile in every eye. Brothers and sisters, won't you hear me shout? Let me hear my joyful cry. There's a meeting here tonight. There's a meeting here tonight. I know you by your friendly face. There's a meeting here tonight. There is a meeting tonight. I know you by your friendly face. There's a meeting here tonight. There's a meeting here tonight. Great God, there's a meeting here tonight. Great God, I know you by your friendly face. There's a meeting here
Kerr. We're all from Waukesha. We all grew up with a whole bunch of you. Some of you were the village that raised us, and it's your fault.
Boy, I was going to pin that on Harlow Knazer.
Oh, yeah. That's right. Music Center.
That's right. That's where we got the tools of ignorance.
Yeah. Our next song we're going to do is one that we didn't really know what the words meant because it's in Yiddish. But we memorized it phonetically. Off the record, and it's an old Limelighter song, and it tells a story of a place in the Crimea, which was in the news in the last year or so, in Ukraine at the time, and it tells of a collective that some Jewish people put together in the 30s, and it failed ultimately, but at the time, it was their big hope, and the song is sort of filled with hope that way. So, when we get to the Yiddish verses, make up your own meaning as we go along.
Sing along.
Yeah. It's called Shankoya.
When you go to Sevastopol on the way to Simferopol, just you go a little further down.
Oh, my God.
Sugar, Billy Bob, and Mona Milka.
Study hall that he would let us do in school every week on his reel-to-reel tape deck. And he had it converted to CD, and he surprised it with me one day, just kind of slipped it onto the CD player while we were talking, and I could hear Steve's banjo. And he had copies for all of us. That's how we were able to do it 10 years ago. Put them in the car when you're driving everywhere. So, thank you again.
And speaking of Jim Mahan, this next song was the one song that after we did it at the talent show our senior year up at South, he said, as we walked off to all four of us, he said, forget the rest of it, but don't ever forget that song. This is it. It's called Seven Daffodils.
Seven golden daffodils.
sun to light our way to evening when our day is done.
And
my God is waiting, you can rise in his arms.
feel discouraged and think my work's in vain. But then the Holy Spirit revives my soul again. If you can't pray like Peter, if you can't preach like Paul, go home and tell your neighbor that he died to save us all. The Lord loves the sinner. The Lord loves the sinner man. The Lord
that I'd forgotten about because I'm living out in California now, is the humidity is back.
And, no!
should have seen how sweaty we were earlier today. Oh, actually, that's why we originally joined the swim team. Yeah, there's a lot of sweat in those pools. In fact, I think a survey recently has shown that 38% of the water in Horeb and Buckner is children's sweat. Keep that in mind next time you go swimming. All right. So,
shape?
Yeah. Here we go.
With the poor, I've been a traveling back, road to freedom gonna keep right on traveling.
Facebook, you've seen Bruce has posts a lot of stuff, so we're going to have a couple of tunes for you right now that he's done. So here he is, Bruce Kerr.
All right. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Steve. Thanks, Steve. The other changes that I've seen in Waukesha coming back this time were kind of interesting. For one thing, I noticed a lot of people now call it Waukesha. We always called it Waukesha. And the E somehow is starting to fade, and I just want to encourage everyone, leave that E in there, because you know where it's going to end up. It's going to be shortened to Waukesha, and everyone's going to ask, what is the meaning of Waukesha? And someone's going to say, well, it's probably the river walk. And someone said, let's take a walk, and the response was, sure. And that's how the city became known as Waukesha. So use it, don't lose it, get the E back in there. The second one I noticed was that the one-way street signs are gone, so you can get anywhere now. But the biggest change is the growth and expansion. And I don't mean the city, I mean the people. In California, I'm overweight. That's why I love to come home to my brothers and sisters. One cop stopped me, thought I was the Slender Man. I am not the Slender Man. Don't hold it against me. So a number of years ago, I got into doing parodies and taking other people's songs and mixing them up and changing the lyrics and all, because I was too lazy to write the song myself. And this is one of them. Originally, we heard this song by the Beatles back in the 60s when we were very young, and it seemed like turning 64 was going to be forever into the future. And we've already passed it. But as I was approaching 64, I thought about twisting the song a bit. So in this version, it's our generation talking to our children with a slightly different message to the song. I think you'll recognize this melody. I'm 64, so listen up, kids. Many years from now, will you still be paying for my managed care? Private nursing, a room I don't share. If I've dementia and we're playing cards, would you keep the score? Will you still visit? Give me a physic when I'm 94. You'll be older too. With an extra room, I could live with you. I could spend hours staring at walls, wouldn't get in your way. Lock me in a rocker by the fireside every morning. My backside, prescriptions, drive to the dock, hold open my door, pay my expenses, change my defenses when I'm 94. Every week we could see dinner at Denny's after getting all fixed up. Help me primp and shave. Great, great grandchildren on my knees. Stating point of view, indicate nicely if you return good deeds. Yours sincerely.
some sort. Okay. How many people have a smartphone, an iPod, an iPad? How many people have a server in their closet that mixes both their business and their personal emails? Just wondering about that one. So this is, if you have any of those, this one's for you. I guess that's pretty much everyone. This is another parody, another take on an old song you may be familiar with. This one's about technology and computers and what may happen one day. Long, long time ago, I can still remember when data, it was written down. But just like a computer goes, data's stored in ones and O's. And what may happen to it, no one knows. I thought my backup was so clever. Some anomaly, whatever, from my monitor I'm greeted. All data deleted. I can't remember if I cried when my system crashed and my files all fried. Something screwed up deep inside. The data died. I started singing, bye bye, kiss your data goodbye. Ran my PC nice and easy. Server just died. I guess I'll go and drink a case of whiskey and rye. Sing and kiss your frickin' data goodbye. Frickin' data goodbye. Did you read a book on DOS? And do you have faith in C++? If a techie tells you so. Now do you believe in MP3? Is copyright the enemy, and of your browser sometimes work real slow. Oh, I know you spend time on your screen, cause your website's like a magazine. Your storage must be vast. How could it disappear so fast? I was a lonely boomer techno freak. Upgraded my system week by week, but I knew I was up the creek. Cursing fool, I thought I'd ask what caused the crash. So I went down to the local store where I bought that system a week before. But the man there said I should have spent more cash. In the streets I saw the millions, their storage gone, they'd all lost billions. From Austin to Arcata, we'd lost all of the data. And the three who'd lost the very most, Google, Larry Ellison, and each web host, all that bread just turned to toast. The data died. And we were singing, bye bye. Madison, Worthington, and South, grade by grade, the bus, hairy wheel, and hard to feel, the musicals, the teens, our time, our place, lives on inside our dreams. Teachers we all had, some days good, some bad, after the class to sports or more. Friend and partner to have teamed up with than Steve. We had a ball. For a couple of years, we lived in a 51 Chevy school bus turned into a camper. And for a portion of that, we each had our girlfriends with us, so that was really interesting. Between the bunks, we had a sheet hanging, so we had no privacy.
When they see my Facebook post, I sign it Superstar Steve, and they think I was being vain. The trouble was, I thought, if we go on the road, are we going to be known as Bruce and Steve, or are we going to be Superstar Steve and Cousin Bruce? And that's
right. That's right. All right, so we thought we'd do one of our songs we did back then. Being a duo, a natural was doing a Simon and Garfunkel song, and this was one of our favorites, so we thought we'd bring it back for you tonight, The Boxer.
I am just a poor boy, though my story's seldom told. I have squandered my resistance, a pocket full of mumbles, such are promises. All lies and jest, still the man hears what he wants to hear, disregards the rest. No more than a boy in a company of strangers, quiet off the railway station, running scared, laying low, seeking out the poorer quarters, with a ragged people go, looking for the places only they would know. Lie, 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 lie
Crying, what can I do? How can I afford these vices? Chelsea
Charlie's wife goes down to the Scottish Square Station every day at 2:15. And through the open window she hears Charlie at Jimmy's Grotto, double Italian sausage, beef with green onions, green peppers, and a panzerotta. As the train goes rumbling in,
but did he ever return? No, he never returned. And his fate is still unlearned. Fight the fair increase,
vote for Hillary Clinton,
Jeb Bush,
Bernie Sanders.
Oh, Bernie Sanders.
Colonel Sanders.
Donald Trump. And the Charlie of the MTA.
Why doesn't she hand him a dime?
Never return, no!